administration and sports leadership while continuing to help the basketball program. With his parents, Greg and Andrea, once again, Noah Howard. Next up, number 32, Tyler Guest. Tyler's a one-year member of the basketball program after transferring from Dominican University. Tyler's appeared in every game this year for the Firebirds, highlighted with a 40-point, 11-rebound effort and a win against Greenville University in November. He's only the ninth player in program history to score 40 points in a game. Tyler will be completing his master's degree in sports management this spring and plans to combine his interest in sports science, community enrichment by serving as a general manager for a youth basketball program in Chicago. He also plans on working part-time as an analyst for a sports performance company serving NBA and EuroLeague teams. Accompanied by his parents, Stephanie and Jack, number 32, Tyler Guest. Next up, number 3, Krishan Cook. Krishan's been a four-year member of the program and has appeared in 44 games in his Firebird career. He's battled through so many injuries throughout the career, but still managed to lead the CCIW in steals in the 2019-2020 season with 47. That's the eighth most in the season in school history. Chris is currently in his final year of graduate school, will graduate with a bachelor's degree in communications and a master's degree in education with a concentration in sports leadership. After Carthage, Krishan hopes to continue his basketball career playing overseas. Escorted today by his mother, Becky Stanley, dad, Krishan Cook, and grandma, Susan Stanley and Cynthia Cook. Once again, number 3, Krishan Cook. And finally, number 10 is Kyle Chirock. Kyle's a four-year member of the Carthage basketball program. He's appeared in 23 games this season, starting 21 of them, and leads the team in three-point field goal percentage, shooting over 42%. Kyle has a terrific work ethic and is one of the best practice players you could ask for. Kyle maintains a 3.96 grade point average and is completing his student teaching at Bradford High School this spring. With a major in math and a minor in secondary education, Kyle plans on becoming a high school math teacher and hopes to coach basketball as well. Escorted by his parents, Mary and Kevin Chirock, number 10, Kyle Chirock. Thank you for all your contributions to the Carthage basketball program these past 4 years. Once again, your Firebird senior.
Welcome into our Senior Day broadcast, everyone. John Weiser with you from the Tarble Arena in Kenosha. We just had the men's Senior Day ceremonies going on. Krishan Cook, Kyle Chirock, Tyler Guest, and student assistant coach Noah Howard honored here today as the outgoing seniors, and some impressive things going on with the senior class. Krishan Cook completing his graduate degree in sports management, finishing out his collegiate career here, hopes to play overseas. Kyle Chirock, who is a three-time academic all-conference selection. And Chirock going to be a high school math teacher, finishing up his student teaching while still coming to practice every day and playing the games. Tells you a lot about his work ethic and how hard he works. And Tyler Guest, transferring in from Dominican University, was a former high school teammate of Philip Wilatovich at Maine South. And he's going to have an outstanding career outside of basketball as well. So great to see that. Noah Howard, who all season long has helped in game prep and has helped both Steve and Brad Emmert work on their coaching and scouting and working with the team as far as videotape and everything else. Noah has done an outstanding job as well. So the seniors getting their due here today. Well, we've got basketball here today. 15th ranked Elmhurst Blue Jays in the building at 10-5 in the league, 18-6 overall. They can get to an 11th win and hopefully get in that second seed if Wheaton would fall today to Millikan. Right now they're sitting as the third seed in the conference tournament. They would host Augustana on Tuesday night. This Blue Jay team, I think, primed for a deep playoff run in the postseason. They are led by Jake Rohde, their senior out of Mount Carmel High School. has 17 points, 3 rebounds per contest. He's made 22 starts on the season, including tonight. And he's coming off a 19-point game in the loss to Milliken the other night. They also have another outstanding senior on this team, two other outstanding seniors on this team. Jay Militello, 9.5 points and a 32% shooter from the three-point arc. And LaVon Thomas, a 6'5 forward. Thomas, team's leading rebounder coming into the game, one of the leading rebounders on this team, I should say, coming into the game here tonight. So that's what we've got in store as the Firebirds look to snap a 5, make it a 6-game losing skid coming in here. And this all started with that double overtime loss to Milliken here on this floor back in late January. And Carthage has had trouble trying to close out ball games. They're coming off a tough loss on the road, or here at home, I should say, Wednesday night against Carroll. And Carroll really looked like the team that wanted it more in that contest, suffice to say, as the Pioneers just outplayed Carthage throughout much of that ball game, and it really was not a very good effort, as Steve Jurakovic pointed out in his post-game discussion with me after the game, that he was disappointed with the result, but not disappointed with the result, and thought he could compete a little bit better, and so the team just kind of lost its fight in the second half. So we'll see how this game goes here today. Carthage cannot let Elmhurst shoot 50% or better from the three-point arc. That's been probably the one constant in this losing skid for the Firebirds, has been the inability to shut down the arc and lock down defensively. And talk about the opposites here between Carthage and Carthage men and the Carthage women. The Carthage women looking for offense, playing good defense. Well, it's the opposite here for the Carthage men. They're looking to play better defense and keep the consistent offense that they have, led by Filip Bulatovic, who comes into the game as the team's leading scorer, 17.5 per game, 8.6 rebounds, and averages nearly 4 assists per contest. Youngsters on this team have performed well as well. A.J. Johnson, Garrett Horner, Colton Sigel, Kyle Kostas, all youngsters. That future looks good offensively. Now if they could just get the defense turned around. Let's head back downstairs to Eric Engel and our starting lineups for our second game today, the 15th-ranked Elmhurst Blue Jays and the Carthage Firebirds.
Time for the starting lineups. First, let's meet the Blue Jays. A guard, 5'11 senior from Chicago Heights, Illinois, number 1, Jake Rohde. A guard, a 6'3 junior from Schiller Park, Illinois, number 2, Ocean Johnson. A guard, a 6'2 junior from Downers Grove, Illinois, number 22, Wesley Hooker. At forward, a 6'5 senior from Bellwood, Illinois, number 23, LaVon Thomas. And at forward, a 6'4 senior from Elmwood Park, Illinois, number 24, Jay Militello. The head coach of the Blue Jays is John Baines, assisted by Peyton Wyatt, John Chang, and Tyler Pierce.
Side.
6'5" junior from Maine South High School, hailing from Harwood Heights, Illinois, number 11, Philip Ulanovich. At forward, a 6'4" sophomore from Wheaton North High School in Wheaton, Illinois, number 30, Garrett Horner. And at forward, a 6'4" senior from Maine South High School, hailing from Chicago, Illinois, number 32, Tyler Guest. The head coach for your Firebirds is Steve Jerkovic. Coach Jerkovic, assisted by Brad Emmer, Quincy French, and Bosco Jerkovic. The student assistant coach is Noah Howard. The results for today's game are Bryce Kahn, Matthew Mock, and Jeff Lewis.
So for the Blue Jays, it'll be Rohde, Johnson, Hooker, Thomas, and Militello. For the Firebirds, Cook, Ulanovich, Horner, Chirac, and Guest. Firebirds have lost six in a row, trying to end that streak here today. They're 4-7 here at home. Blue Jays coming off a home loss to Milliken on Wednesday night, 74-64, the upstart Big Blue with that victory. Militello will jump with Bolanovich in the opening tip, brought down by Chirac and the Carthage Firebirds. We are underway. Game two of our doubleheader. The Firebirds looking for a sweep this afternoon. Tyler Guest in the starting lineup along with Chirac for three. Now that'll skip off, and the rebound pulled in by LaVon Thomas. Militello down the right side, cut off by Ulanovich, turns, shoots over Ulanovich, missing. Whistle and a foul. Ooh. Foul's going to go on Garrett Horner. So Blue Jays will retain possession here. Rohde will inbound to Thomas. Wesley Hooker with it back to Thomas, backing in on the paint. Double team forced out by Guest. Good job defensively here. Five on the shot clock. Militello slips inside. Reverse layup won't go. And Guest with the rebound for the Firebirds. Cook gets it to Bolanovich. Three on the way. That one is no good. Carthage 0-2 now from long distance. Thomas, cross-court feed. Ocean Johnson to Rohde, to Hooker, to Thomas, and good. Good ball rotation that time by the Blue Jays. Worked it completely around the perimeter before Thomas was able to finish. 2-0 Elmhurst. Now Ulanovich through the paint to Cook for three. That one's no good. Carthage 0-3 now. Too quick in the offensive set with those shots. Ocean Johnson, back iron miss. Cook tracks it down for the Firebirds. Now Guest to Chirac. Kyle Chirac, what a leader. Ulanovich for three, that won't fall. Cook got the offensive board, goes over Thomas. Missed the shot, knocked to the floor, no call. Back come the Blue Jays the other way. Hooker's pass slips to the hands of Militello, out of bounds. Carthage will bring it up from the backcourt, looking for their first points today. One other game about to tip off. That'll be North Park and Carroll out in Waukesha on the men's side. Everything else later tonight. Ninth-ranked Wesleyan at Augustana, and Ulanovich called for the offensive foul on the wipe away, trying to drive the left block, knocking Militello to the floor. Second. Thomas hands it off to Johnson, to Hooker. Rohde gave up the shot to Militello, driving, lays it in. Militello flashing in from the right side on the feed from Rohde. 4-0 Blue Jays. Chirac has pass deflected, picked up by Horner. He's looking inside and had his pocket stripped that time by Hooker. Back the other way. Wesley Hooker puts it up. No good. Danced off the rim. Able to track it down, though, in the corner, and flips it up top to Rohde. Now Thomas to Militello. Back to Ocean Johnson. Now Hooker for three. In and out. Thomas trying to go over the back of Tyler Guest. We'll get the foul. LaVon Thomas going over the back of Guest. First foul on the Blue Jays. 4-0 Elmhurst here in the early going. Guest making his second start of the season. He started the game against Greenville. Became the ninth player in history with the overhead lob. Senior to senior, Chirac to Guest. And then Militello got knocked down, and the foul on Krishan Cook, I believe. Let's see. Yep. How about that play? The two seniors hooking up there. Chirac and Guest with the alley-oop slam. That got the bench all up in arms. For the Firebirds. I think they had that planned. Rohde traveled. Tried to go through Bilatovic that time, who stopped him at the free throw line and off balance took the extra step. Chirac trying to get past Rohde, back out to Horner, now to Guest. Gives it off to Krishan Cook. Cross court to Bilatovic, driving in right side. Bilatovic over Militello is short. Militello is going to have his hands full today with Bilatovic. Inside. Foul called on the little hitch and go that time by Wesley Hooker. He'll get to the line and shoot a pair. Chirac with the foul. First, team fourth. Hooker for free throw is good. 61% shooter out of Downers Grove South. Jonathan Zapinski in, the 6'6 junior for the Blue Jays. Nemi Ostojic in, along with A.J. Johnson for the Firebirds. And Guest gets the rebound off the miss by Wesley Hooker. 5-2 Blue Jays. Through the ball screen set by Ostojic. Now Bilatovic out of the left corner, working on Militello. Pass behind Guest, and it's taken away by Rohde. Nice look to Militello in the finish, low left. Rohde to Militello. We're going to hear that quite a bit tonight. 7-2 Blue Jays. And now the foul called on Wesley Hooker, trying to go around the back of Krishan Cook for the steal. First on Hooker, second on the team. Carthage possession in front of the Blue Jay bench. Bilatovic now to A.J. Johnson. He's going to be a good one in this league before it's all said and done. Bulk him up just a little bit. 10 to shoot here for the Firebirds, and Bilatovic into the corner. Guest. Jump stop in the paint. Extra pass broken up inside by Ocean Johnson. Hooker will go down for the layup. Timeout Carthage. 9-2 run to start the ball game for the Blue Jays. They lead it by 7, 5 minutes in. Carthage 1-for-7, 0-for-4 at the arc. Tyler Guest, the only bucket on the alley-oop dunk for the Firebirds. Meanwhile, it's Militello with 4, Thomas with 2. Blue Jays 3-for-8, 0-for-2 at the arc. They have out-rebounded Carthage 7-5 here in the early going. Carthage and Elmhurst locked up on a Monday. It was a makeup for a game lost earlier in January to COVID protocol on Elmhurst. And the 21st ranked Blue Jays at the time knocked off the Firebirds 88-74 at Faginal Hall. So Carthage would love to turn the tables here, but turn it over. Oh, they don't. Last to touch with the Blue Jays, so it'll be Carthage ball. In for the Blue Jays, Zapinski. Dominic Jenko in there now, the 6'3 senior out of Zionsville, Ohio. Jenko averaging almost 10 points a game. Miladovic with the inbound pass to Kostas, and he'll fire and hit the three-pointer off the right wing. Kyle Kostas, who's had quite a freshman year. 19 points in the game against the Blue Jays earlier this season. Gets his first three here tonight. Rohde, a deep three on the way, and good. Stepped into an open look that time and drained it. 12-5 now in favor of the Blue Jays. Kostas again to Nemia Stojic. Cross court it goes. Bolatovic wants a three, won't get it. Rohde will come away with it. Rohde across midcourt. Got to stop the dribble. Jump stop in the paint. Back out it goes, Jenko. On the arc, Zapinski. Back over to Rohde. Zapinski will set the ball screen. Rohde will shoot over it. He'll miss. Ball knocked out of bounds from behind. Ooh. Zapinski had it in his hands, but they call it off a Carthage player. Hunter Merritt will check in now, replacing Jay Militello for the Blue Jays. Rohde to the free throw line. Zapinski backing down on Johnson. Kicks it to the open wing. Hunter Merritt's three dances off, no good. We got an offensive foul going for the rebound. Zapinski with a push off. Extended the arms to try and get position underneath. First on Zapinski, third on the team. Carthage will bring it down, trailing by seven. Vladovic had it stolen away by Rohde. Good double team there. Rohde down the floor, got fouled hard by Horner, and Horner picks up his second foul. Talk about it here. Is that going to be an intentional foul or not? Officials are huddling. John Baines is whining. And they're going to call an intentional foul. And that's going to bring Steve Jerkovic onto the floor. So two free throws plus possession here for the Blue Jays. As Horner picks up his second foul. Not sure I call that an intentional foul, but certainly a hard foul. So Rohde makes the first of two, plus the Blue Jays will keep possession here. They'll have 20 on the shot clock and will inbound underneath. Vladovic will sit down and Horner will sit down. Antoine Nesbitt and Colton Sigel. Pair of freshmen in now for the Firebirds. Nesbitt, the freshman from the Prairie School. Sigel, freshman from Rock Island High School. Jenko, pull-up jumper, crawls off no good. Nesbitt had to go through his hands. It's loose up top. Kostas with it. Kostas forgot the basketball and had it picked away, and then took it right back the other way. Back-to-back turns by the same two players. Nesbitt works it off now. Sigel back to Nesbitt. His pass broken up nicely. Jenko getting a hand on it to knock it away. 17 on the shot clock here for the Firebirds. Facing their biggest deficit now at 9. Pass, errant pass inside, taken away by the Blue Jays. That's six turnovers already for the Firebirds. Missing the layup that time. Now we got a whistle and a foul. Nesbitt able to get in there for the rebound. Hooker wasn't sure if he was going to dunk it or if he was going to lay it in, and left it short. And in the battle for the rebound, Bryce Drews, who just came into the game, picks up the foul. Cook back in there now, replacing Kyle Kostas. Sigel with it. It's a very quick, very good, handsy defense by the Blue Jays this year. Sigel for three. In and out, no good. The rebound, Zapinski. Hooker will bring it across. Hooker to the top of the circle. And we'll drop it inside. Zapinski. Cross court it goes. Jenko gave it up. Gave it back to Hooker. Tried to roll it in. Broken up by Cook. Goes out of bounds. It'll be Carthage. Double deflection as it went off of Cook, then deflected off Zapinski. Out of bounds. Kostas in for A.J. Johnson. As Steve trying to rotate his guards in here. Stojic with it now. Top of the circle. To Kostas, now to Nesbitt. Gives it to Krishan Cook. Cook wants a three. Won't get it. Carthage cold shooting the last three ball games from long distance. Need to attack the rim. One for eight now. Off balance jumper, no good. Rebound pulled in by Kostas. Hooker missed a couple of close range ones here for the Blue Jays. Now Kostas floats with the right hand. Got it up. No. Kept alive by Cook on the glass. And it's taken down by Zapinski. They'll quickly clear across midcourt. Jenko. Left hand layup won't fall. Off of Zapinski. He'll track it down in the corner. Hunter Merritt for three. That's way off. And now Sigel will pick it up for Carthage. 11-10. Blue Jays with a one rebound lead. 9 minutes gone by here in this first half. Carthage chasing nine. Kostas through the paint. Back out to Sigel. Ball fakes, puts it on the floor, gets it back out. Kostas will take the three. That one will curl off, no good, and the rebound pulled in by Hooker. Carthage well beyond cold here. 2 for 13, 1 for 9 now from long distance. Now the Blue Jays will take a timeout. 10.5 minutes to go here in this first half, and Carthage down 14-5, and as I said, shooting woes continue to plague this team. 2 for 14, 1 for 10 at the arc so far for the Firebirds today. Meanwhile, the Blue Jays 5 for 16, 31%, 1 for 6 at the arc, 3 for 4 at the line. 13-10, Blue Jays the advantage on the glass. Three offensive boards already for Elmhurst so far. They've scored 8 points off of the 6 Carthage turnovers thus far. Blue Jays by 9, it'll be their ball. After they take a timeout here. LeVon Thomas back into the lineup. To Ocean Johnson. Now to Wesley Hooker. Hold it into Thomas. Mismatch there. Trying to get around Sigel. Went up and down with it. Oh, they're going to call a foul. Boy, it looked like he traveled with it. Foul will go on Anthony Bernero, saying he held him. They'll put LeVon Thomas at the line. Both Bernero and Sigel trying to double team Thomas. Awfully close to a travel there, but they'll call the foul. Thomas, a pretty good shooter from the line, 70% on the year. He had 14 points in the win over Carthage back at the end of January, as Bulatovic will check in now for Sigel. Hits both free throws here. Largest lead at 11 now for Elmhurst. 16-5. Cook, Bulatovic, Kostas, Bernero, and Nesbitt out there. Kostas to Nesbitt. Nesbitt working on Rohde. Back out to Bernero, to Bulatovic. Into the low post. Nesbitt working on Rohde again. Going to the basket. Get knocked to the floor. It's loose. And picked up underneath by Thomas. A couple of looks that time. Rohde nearly threw it away. Back to Thomas now. Rohde, chicken wing, offensive foul. Stuck out the arm into Bernero. Got called for the offensive foul. That's his first, fifth on the team. Nesbitt trying to get around Rohde. Now Bolatovic to Bernero. Gets it to Christian Cook. Got past both Hooker and Thomas and lays it in with the left hand. Oh, what a nice move. Able to split both Thomas and Hooker that time and then go into the paint, changed hands, went up with the left hand and finished. First two tonight for Cook. Hooker top of the circle to Rohde. That three is off. Rebound Bernero. Had it go off of him. Saved by Kostas right into the hands of Bernero. Now Cook will run things here up top. Will step into a three and hit. Christian Cook for the triple, top of the circle. Five straight by Cook, cuts the deficit to six. Thomas wants a three, won't get it. Kostas with the rebound. Bolatovic, there was contact with Militello, got it away, didn't fall, got a held ball inside. Possession arrow going back to the Blue Jays. Militello and Thomas battling Bernero and Kostas there for that possession. Bryce Drews and Jonathan Zapinski back in for Elmhurst. Bernero will sit down for Carthage. Stojic will come back in. 8.5 minutes to go, first half. Carthage down six. Zapinski gets it off to Hooker. Wesley Hooker. Nice feed back to Zapinski. Got around to Stojic. Lays it up left hand. No. They missed three or four of those now from 0 foot range. Bolatovic to Kostas. Back to Bolatovic. Off balance. Missed it. Loose. Bolatovic trying to come out of there with it. Still loose. Goes off of Rohde. And they're going to say it's going to be Blue Jay ball, or what do we got? A foul? It's going to be a foul on Carthage on Philip Bolatovic trying to dribble out of that traffic. Picks up his second. That'll put Rohde on the free throw line, shooting the 1-1. Among the league leaders in scoring at 17 points per game is Rohde. 79% from the free throw line. 19 points the other night against Milliken in the loss at home on his senior night. Second one drops in as well. Rohde with 7 first half points. The lead out to 8 for the Blue Jays. Cook to Kostas. Going hard left side and was fouled. Zapinski. Leave with the foul. Nope, they're going to give it on Militello. Nope, they're going to call it on Zapinski. That's his second. Sixth on the Blue Jays, and so at the line will be Kyle Kostas shooting two. 70% shooter from the line. Freshman out of Lamont, Illinois. As Kyle Shirak will check back in, replacing Antoine Nesbitt. And Kostas goes 2 for 2. 5 points for Kyle. 6-point deficit. Rohde. Zapinski now to Militello. Back underneath. Drews. Missed the shot. Now the rebound. Pulled out of there. Shirak in the right corner. Kostas wants a three. Won't get it. Militello with the rebound. Carthage 2 for 11 now at the arc in this half. Militello, turnaround jumper in the paint is good. Jay Militello with 6 points. 8 point Blue Jay lead. Chirac. It's a back. Free throw line jumper by Bulatovic won't fall. Loose inside, taken by the Blue Jays. Drews gets it away to Rohde. To Hooker, back to Rohde for three. Got it. Transition bucket for the Blue Jays. Rohde with 10 first half points. Largest lead on 11 now, 23-12. Cook for three, got it. Christian Cook, and a technical foul on Cook coming across midcourt. Cook teed up, not for what he did, for what he said. He was getting razzed by the Blue Jay bench and had something to say on his way back across midcourt after sinking that triple. So Cook will pick up the technical, which is also his second personal foul, and Rohde makes one of two. Carthage will make some substitutions here. It'll be A.J. Johnson and Colton Sigel coming back in. Get Cook off the floor here, let him settle down a little bit. So after he hit that pull-up jumper, he had something to say to the bench, and the officials put an end to it. Rohde back out to Wesley Hooker, to Militello. Cut off by Bulatovic on the baseline. They work it back up top, Rohde. No look, pass down the lane and a layup. That time by Zapinski. His first two, Chirac for three, that one won't go. Rebound, or Sigel's three-pointer, no good. Rebound by Chirac. Carthage will reload here. Bulatovic spins in the paint, reversing with the right hand and lays it in. Bulatovic with his first bucket, 1 for 7 now this afternoon. 10-point deficit. Zapinski going to come up short. Bulatovic able to get the rebound. Into the corner, Chirac for three. No. 3 for 14 now, shooting the long ball. Stojic trying to defend Militello. Got around to Stojic. Lost control of the basketball. Loose in the paint. Bulatovic will break it out. Down the right side, Bulatovic, and he was fouled on the floor before the shot. Drews with the foul, his third. Bernero will come in, replacing a Stojic. Jenko will come back in along with Thomas and Ocean Johnson for the Blue Jays. Bonus here, 1-1 for Philip Bulatovic. Harwood Heights native, Maine South graduate. That one is short, but the diving board over the front and down. Struggled at the line all season. 46% this year at the line. You look at his other numbers, 17.5 per game, 8 rebounds, 4 assists. Can't help but wonder, raise that free throw percentage up a good 20 points, he'd be averaging 20 points a game. 27-19 Blue Jays, Ocean Johnson with it to LaVon Thomas, guarded by Bernero. Try to roll it inside, it goes through, and it will be Carthage ball. Turns into the sixth turnover for the Blue Jays. Turnovers even now at a half dozen apiece. Under 5 to go here in the first half. Carthage trailed by as many as 12 here. Bernero, spin move in the paint and lays it in from the left side. Jenko thought he was gonna get charged, take the charge, but Bernero pirouetted around him. Nice move by the sophomore from Indian Trail. Hooker for three. Back iron miss. Hit the top of the backboard. Back tap by Devon Thomas, and then off the shoulder of Militello. Bulatovic doing the job there. Dumped it off the shoulder of Militello. Carthage will keep possession. Chance to get close here. Flop that time by Militello, no call. Three on the way, that one is no good. Back tapped out by Bernero, and it goes off Ocean Johnson. Carthage possession with 20 on the shot clock. There is a flop warning now on Militello. Wasn't even close to being a charge. Shira. Bernero for a three. Oh, it's short. Ocean Johnson with the rebound. Just his third three-point attempt of the year, or sixth three-point attempt of the year. Now we got a whistle and a foul. Johnson and Jenko continued on after the play. Officials have to get this order restored here. A garbage play here by both teams. Getting out of hand. Kostas in for Chirac. Bonus free throws here for Jay Militello. Senior out of Elmwood Park and Fenway High School. Missed. Kostas with the rebound. Remains a 6-point deficit here. 3:35 to go in the half. Bulatovic bumped by Johnson, no call. Kostas picks it up. Gets it to Sigel, fakes Militello, and hits the three. Ball fake got Militello off the floor, and then after the play, Bernero knocked hard to the floor. He was tangled up with LaVon Thomas. We may have it. Let's see what we got here. I'm going to call Bernero for a hold. I'll tell you what, play is getting chippy here between these two schools this afternoon. Militello, the flopper, will come out. Militello's got to come back into the ball game. Double bonus, so he's got to wait. Dominic Jenko at the free throw line. Missing the front end. One for two as he hits the back end here. Jake Rohde will come in for Jenko. 3:25 to play. It's a 4-point game, 28-24. Carthage trailed by as many as 12 here in the first half. They've battled back. Bulatovic driving left side, banks it in. 8-2 run here by the Firebirds. They've pulled it within two. Hooker for three. Short. Rebound, Johnson. Rohde trying to reach in and take it away. They get it up to Bulatovic. Chance to tie here on this possession. Again, working on Zapinski, and the foul called. Bulatovic will get to the line. Jonathan Zapinski picking up the foul, his second, eighth on the team. Bulatovic will shoot two. Nemi Stojic will come in now. He will replace Anthony Bernero. It's a good play by Bernero here in the early going. And Bulatovic ties it at the free throw line. Knotted at 28 here late in the first half. Largest lead was 27-15, and Carthage has come back here on a nice little run, 12-1 run, and they force the turnover. Carthage ball here. Militello will check back in, replacing Wesley Hooker. Carthage with a chance to take their first lead in the game on this possession, 2.5 to play. Johnson, cut off by Rohde. Leaves it for Bulatovic on the wing. He'll fire the three. It hits! Philip Bulatovic now with 11 points. Carthage, their first lead, 31-28. 2:15 to go in the half. Levon Thomas. Zapinski to Rohde. And a steal. Oh, and Kostas couldn't quite get there as he broke up that pass, but lost his footing trying to break it out. Blue Jay ball with 12 to shoot, 2:02 to play. Levon Thomas. Now to Militello. Shot clock down to one. They get it away. Ocean Johnson missing. Shot clock violation. The students here starting to fire up this Carthage team. Last 4.5 minutes, Carthage on a 16-3 run. Take a three-point lead. Vladovic to the basket. Counted in one! Bulatovic back to the free throw line for the three-point play. This will be 8 points in a row here for Bulatovic if he connects here on the free throw. Hunter Merritt coming in now, replacing Zapinski. Free throw is good for Bulatovic. 22-5 run by Carthage here in the last 5 minutes of this second half. Thomas fouled as he went to the basket. He'll get to the free throw line here for the Blue Jays. Kostas with the foul. That is his first. Levon Thomas back at the free throw line for the Blue Jays. First miss at the line for Thomas tonight. Has 4 points to go with 4 rebounds. Got that one to go, 1 for 2. 34-29, Firebirds, minute 25 remaining here in this first half. Bulatovic, pull-up three-pointer, that one barely drew iron. Ostojic with the offensive board, turns around and hits. Double-teamed, able to beat the double-team and hit the soft jumper in the paint. 36-29. Thomas, spinning into the paint. Lost it on the way up, loose on the floor. Ostojic comes away with it. Bulatovic with the quick hands that time. Under a minute to go in the half. Now Rohde gets a steal off the miscue by Bulatovic. Will feed it, Hunter Merritt, laid it short, he blew the layup. Hunter Merritt all by himself, and now the wild pass by Sigel deflects off of Ostojic. Play getting sloppy here in the final minute. Antoine Nesbitt going to come in now. He's going to replace Philip Bulatovic. 14 points tonight for Bulatovic, but more importantly, he's gone 5 for 5 at the free throw line. Again, coming in was just 46% from the stripe this year. Militello got called for a flop earlier. Gives it off to Levon Thomas. Ocean Johnson back to Thomas. Ball fake, got around to Stojic, leans with the right hand off the glass, cuts it to 5. Carthage with the final shot here. They'll take a lead into the locker room. Nesbitt with seven. Got around Thomas. Nesbitt hard to the basket. Knocked to the floor. Tip up by Stojic. Goes down. Time runs out, and a frustrated Blue Jay team will hit the locker room here at the half. Carthage, down by as many as 12 with 6 minutes remaining, have come back to take a 7-point lead at the break. Firebirds 38, Elmhurst 31. Well, a physical first half here this afternoon between these two teams. Carthage battling all the way back, making a 23-4 run to close out this first half. Carthage was down 27-15 with just under 6 minutes left, and then came roaring back on 8 points in a row by Philip Bulanovic. And then some help by Nemi Stojic with four down that stretch. Bernero with a couple. Colton Sigel with a three. And Carthage closing out the first half on a 23-4 run to take a 38-31 lead here at the break. Carthage found their shooting touch here in the back end of this first half. First 15 minutes, nothing was going down. At one point, they were 1-for-10 shooting the arc from the arc. And they've finished that half 5-for-19. In the game, Firebirds 13-for-35, 37%. Meanwhile, for the Blue Jays, 9-for-29, 31%, and 2-for-11 at the arc. Blue Jays did get to the line, though, in that first half, 11-of-15, compared to 7-for-7 for Carthage at the charity stripe. Individually in that first half, Philip Bulanovic with 14. He was 4 of 11 from the field. Made all five of his free throws so far tonight. 14 points for Bulanovic. 8 points for Krishan Cook. Cook, his last bucket, a jump shot that went down, and as he let go of the ball, come back in front of the Blue Jay bench right out near center court, had some words and got slapped with a technical foul. He finished with 8 in that first half, going 3-of-6, including a pair of three-pointers. Kyle Kostas with 5, 1-for-3 at the arc, 2-for-2 at the line for Kostas. Stojic with 4, 2-for-2 tonight, including that tap-in late. 3 points for Colton Sigel, part of that 23-4 run. Tyler Guest, who started the game as a senior tonight, finished with 2 points in that first half. Garrett Horner picked up a couple of quick fouls in the ball game, played just 6 minutes, no score. And A.J. Johnson yet to score, yet to attempt a shot, played 10 minutes, did not attempt a shot in that first half. Antoine Nesbitt 0-for-2. Completes the scoring here for the Firebirds. Meanwhile, for the Blue Jays, they were led by, who else? Jake Rohde. Their leading scorer coming in, averaging better than 17 a game, had 12 in that first half, 2-for-4 from the field. Both of those three-pointers, made all 6 of his free throws, finishing with 12 points. 7 points for LaVon Thomas, 6 for Jay Militello, 3 for Wesley Hooker, 2 for John Zapinski, and 1 for Dominic Jenko. Rebounding for the Blue Jays, I should say Carthage actually out-rebounded the Blue Jays in that first half, 23-20. Carthage getting 5 on the offensive glass, 3 offensive boards for the Blue Jays. Leading rebounder for Elmhurst, Thomas and Militello each with 4. Leading rebounders for Carthage, Kostas with 5, Bulanovic with 4. Carthage forced 9 turnovers in that first half, leading to 10 points. Carthage turned it over 8 times, also leading to 10 Blue Jay points. Not many assists, a lot of one-on-one action tonight. Carthage with only 5 helpers, Elmhurst with 6 in that first half.
Johnson Financial Group.
And on those offensive rebounds, Carthage with five, the Blue Jays with three, Carthage 6-0 in second chance points so far tonight. And they lead it here at the break, 38-31. One other game going on. Halftime in Waukesha, North Park leading the Carroll men 35-33 at the half. Osborne with 11, the only player in double figures for North Park. Justin Steineke with 13 to lead the way for Carroll. Again, that's North Park 35, Carroll 33. The end of the first half. Games tonight, ninth-ranked Wesleyan at Augustana, and Milliken is at Wheaton tonight. Again, all six spots for the conference tournament are locked in. Illinois Wesleyan has secured the number one seed. They will host the semifinals next weekend. Wheaton holding the number two seed currently at 11-4. They would hold it outright with a victory over Milliken tonight. Elmhurst at 10-5, sitting in third spot. North Central wrapped up their season Wednesday night. They finished 10-6. They're in the fourth spot. Milliken at 9-6. They hold down the fifth spot, and Augustana is in the sixth spot. So the six teams are set for the conference tournament as it stands right now. Augustana would be at Elmhurst, the sixth seed at the three seed Tuesday night, and Milliken would be at North Central in Naperville Tuesday night. That would be the 5-4 seed. And then the highest seed remaining would be taking on Wheaton Friday night at 7 down in Bloomington. And the lowest seed remaining will take on Illinois Wesleyan in the second game Friday night, with the winners to meet Saturday night for the automatic bid into the Division III tournament. 38-31, Carthage here at the half. Bulatovic with 14 for the Firebirds. Rohde with 12 for the Elmhurst Blue Jays. Well, as I did in the first game, wanted to throw my 2 cents into everything that's going on as far as who my picks would be for the awards coming up this week for All Conference and Coach of the Year. And I'm still leaning very heavily on Most Outstanding Player and Matt Helwig getting that nod from North Central. Led the conference in scoring, better than 23 per game, almost 8 rebounds per contest. That put him in the top 5. Led the conference in free throw shooting percentage at 89%. Averaged 3.1 assists per game, a 1.2 assist to turnover rate. I think Matt Helwig deserves that Most Outstanding Player award. As far as Coach of the Year goes, again, the way the coaches have done it in the past in the CCIW, it seems to mean that the team that wins the conference outright, in this case Illinois Wesleyan, everything would be leaning toward Ron Rose getting the Coach of the Year. But if I had a vote in it, my vote certainly would be for Kramer Soderberg and what he has done in Milliken. Again, the team that was picked last has never finished in the top half of the conference in the better part of a decade. And Kramer Soderberg turning that program around, and with a win tonight would get to 10 wins. They didn't have, but there was a stretch there where they won only 2 games the entire year, back-to-back seasons. And attitude has changed. Kramer Soderberg has done a good job recruiting and hanging on, and of course helps to have Kelvin Fisher on your team as well. But Kramer Soderberg certainly deserves to be recognized as Coach of the Year. I mean, a team that was picked to finish dead last, I mean, among the coaches in the preseason poll, and has his team locked in as the 5th seed in the conference tournament. I'd say that's worthy of Coach of the Year selection. And as far as the all-conference team goes, certainly I think you go with Matt Laritz from Illinois Wesleyan. Certainly has to be in that mix. Adam from Wheaton, certainly in that mix. Jake Rohde, Elmhurst up there, Matt Helwig in there. Then at that fifth spot, going back and forth, I mean, you could certainly go with, I'm sure you, Dan Carr might be considered there. That's who I'm leaning on it. So I'd go with Laritz, Carr, Adam, Rohde, and Helwig, and then put Calvin Fisher, Ethan Helwig, Philip Bulanovich, Kate Elioth, and Blaze Meredith into that second team category for all conference. Again, it's all up for debate. Coaches will nominate their players, but again, for the for what it's worth category, I thought I'd throw my two cents in. Matt Helwig getting the most outstanding player and coach of the year should go to Kramer Soderberg at Milliken. Right now, we've got a great ball game, a great second half coming our way here at the Tarble Arena. Carthage 38-31 lead here at the half. They were down 27-15 with 6 minutes left here in the first half and then ran out the final 6 minutes on a 23-4 run. Filip Bulatovic scoring 8 points in a row. He has 14 tonight to lead the way for the Firebirds on 4 of 11 shooting. Made all five of his free throws here tonight. I guess what that might be the more amazing story, because coming into this game and all season long, Bulatovic has struggled at the free throw line, just at a 46% clip. In the last time out against this Blue Jay team, he had just 5 points on 2 for 11 shooting. So already has bettered his effort here in the second go-round against this Elmhurst team. Big thank you to all of our sponsors again this year. Right now it's the Rustic Subs Sub Toss going on just below us. And again, a thank you to Rustic Subs. Been with us all season long as a proud sponsor of Carthage College Athletics. Rustic Subs, 1830 27th Avenue in Kenosha, just west of the Carthage campus. Open every day, 6 to 8, breakfast, lunch, and dinner. The Rustic Subway, a game changer. Subs done the old and right way, one at a time. That's Rustic Subs, 1830 27th Avenue in Kenosha. Stay with us here in the second half as well. Texas Roadhouse, proud sponsor of Carthage Athletics. The visiting team misses two consecutive free throws here in the second half. Fans will get a free appetizer at Texas Roadhouse, Highway 50, I-94 in Kenosha, Highway 11, Highway 31 in Mount Pleasant. Big thank you to Hampton Inn and Suites and the Candlewood Suites of Kenosha for supporting Carthage Athletics this year. And also want to thank the folks at Freighter Kenosha, the official sports medicine provider of Carthage Athletics, a leader in cardiovascular care and orthopedic care you can count on from a team you can trust. That's Freighter Kenosha and the Medical College of Wisconsin. Stay with us. Second half action coming your way in just a couple of minutes.
Baseball guys,
Second half set to begin here at the Tarble Arena. The Firebirds closing out that first half on a 23-4 run and lead it here 38-31 as we get set to start the second half. Krishan Cook back out on the floor for Carthage to start our second half. It'll be Cook, Anthony Bernero, A.J. Johnson, Kyle Kostas, and Philip Buladovic. Ocean Johnson, Wesley Hooker, LaVon Thomas, Jake Rohde, and Jay Militello for the Blue Jays. Carthage will get the ball to begin the second half. Need to close this one out. That's been a problem for the Firebirds all season long. They've had leads into the second half, and they get into a 3 to 5 minute lull. Now what do we got? Problem with the timing mechanism. Now we got it set. It's a problem with the shot clock there. Now they got it fixed. Bernero high on the right to Kostas, back to Cook. Wesley Hooker on Cook. Now Buladovic working on Jay Militello. We told you about that matchup beginning of the game, and Buladovic with a floater off the left baseline. Buladovic with 16 now. Right at his season average. He averages 17 a game. Von Thomas backing in on Bernero. Turns on Bernero. Over Bernero. Missing. Rebound. Ocean Johnson squeaking in the left side. Able to tap it home. Failure to box out that time. Lack of a pinch there. Vladovich's pass broken up. Hooker down the floor. Will slam it home. Wesley Hooker on a jam, 4-0 run here. 4-2 run, I should say, by the Blue Jays. 5-point lead. Bernero, triple team. That left Kostas open for the three, missing. A.J. Johnson got a rebound. Krishan Cook lost it. Had to shovel a pass to Bernero and had it broken up. Rohde to Hooker. Missed everything. Save from going out, back to Hooker, now to Rohde. Ocean Johnson with that nice save, keep that ball from going out. Militello all day knocks it down. Jay Militello stepping into a three, and now it's a 2-point game. Kostas. Back out to Buladovic. Buladovic dishes to Bernero. Back up top to Kostas, around to Cook. Wants a three, no. Skips off into the corner. Bernero saved it, but right into the hands of Wesley Hooker. Chance to tie or regain the lead here for the Blue Jays. Hooker down the lane with the right hand, leans over Cook and lays it in. Wesley Hooker. Nice flash to the basket that time, and quickly we're tied at 40. Buladovic near side, gives it off to Kostas. Got around Ocean Johnson to the basket and in. Kyle Kostas, and quickly a timeout taken here by Carthage, try and regroup. On the other end, they have allowed the Blue Jays here to get back to within two. Actually tie the game at 40. So the Firebirds, as apt to do here, taking a quick timeout early in the second half. Carthage with four timeouts remaining, the Blue Jays with five. Same five out there for Carthage: Buladovic, Bernero, Kostas, Johnson, and Cook. Rohde, Hooker, Thomas, Militello. Ocean Johnson also out there. Hooker cut off by Bernero. Johnson left all alone in the corner. Play was a design play. They had Ocean standing in that corner. Johnson left all alone, steps in and knocks a three. Blue Jays back up by one. Now Cook, near side Johnson, getting around Militello, got hung up in the air, back over to Cook. Gets it to Costas. Costas down the left side again, lays it up and in, got around Ocean Johnson to the basket. Costas now with nine. 44-43, Firebirds. Militello on the left side to LaVon Thomas over Bernero, in and out. Costas there on the boards for Carthage. 25-23 advantage on the glass for the Firebirds. Costas again, shoveled it off to Bernero, left block, back again on Thomas. Thomas cuts him off. Back out it goes Bulatovic. Got Militello, ran into Bernero, ball off of Bulatovic, out of bounds. Oh, nice ball screen set by Bernero. Militello back to the floor that time. Stojic back in now for Carthage, along with Kyle Shirak. Firebirds by one. They led by seven at the half, 38-31. Outscored 12-6 here in this second half. Hooker, bounce feed to Thomas. Hands to Rohde. Rohde, couple of moves, now back to Thomas. Back out to Ocean Johnson in the corner, Militello. Backing in on Bulatovic to the paint. Fadeaway jumper over Bulatovic won't go. Back tap by Thomas to Rohde. Inside Militello again through three players. Missed it. Still loose. Third possession here for Elmhurst. Christian Cook coming across the top. Got called for the foul. Now what do we got? We got words in a huddle here. We may have a technical foul on Kyle Shirak. That's one of the first times I've seen Shirak get in the middle of stuff. This has been a physical game. It's been a lot of chattering, a lot of talking, back and forth. Second technical of the game, both on Carthage. One on Christian Cook, one on Shirak. And Steve Jerkovic has had enough. He's pleading his case here. They were in a stack following that dead ball, and there were words exchanged, and Shirak must have been the loudest because he was the one that was teed up. Ocean Johnson now working on Colton Sigel. Got around Sigel, lays it up and in. 3-point lead now for the Blue Jays, 47-44. Bulatovic for three. No. Rebound pulled in by Wesley Hooker. Quick outlet to Rohde. Rohde somehow got it to LaVon Thomas. Rohde in the corner, back to Thomas. He thought about a three, raised up, pulled it back in. Now Rohde with it. 12 to shoot here for the Blue Jays. Hooker cut off. Into the corner, Militello raising up on Bulatovic. Now pulls it down and up and in. 7-0 run here by the Blue Jays. They're back up by six. 5 minutes into our second half. Costas on the drive, collides with Thomas, no call. And now a technical foul on Kyle Costas. Or is it on Christian Cook? I'll tell you what, the officials have lost complete control of this ball game here tonight. They have had trouble all game long, and this is on the guys in stripes tonight. They've picked and choose when to lay off technicals here tonight. It's been a chippy game, a lot of chirping, and Steve Jerkovic trying to settle his team down. As Rohde again will shoot the technical. These are three technical fouls now on Carthage today. John Baines over there on that sideline looking like a choir boy. Elmhurst just as much as Carthage flapping their jaws. Now a technical foul called on Steve Jurkovic. Nope, they didn't call. I thought they had teed up Steve as well, but ...52-46. Favor of the Blue Jays. Hooker to Thomas, getting around Bernero. Foul called on Bernero. That's his third. Fourth team foul on Carthage. No fouls on Elmhurst yet here in the second half. We played almost 6 minutes. Levon Thomas, 7 points tonight, 3 for 4 at the free throw line. Missing that one, got a chance. Misses here, free appetizers from Texas Roadhouse. Well, I have to wait again. Thomas goes 1 for 2, hitting the back end, he's got 8. Lead is to 7 now, 53-46. A.J. Johnson top of the circle. Guarded by Wesley Hooker nicely there. Gets it off to Bilatovic. Mismatch there, working on Thomas. Got Thomas off his feet and off the floor. Thomas was running down the corridor that time, trying to chase down Bilatovic, lost him underneath the basket. Bilatovic now with 18. Three on the way by Ocean Johnson, won't go. Battle for the rebound. Bernero was on the floor. They're going to call him for the foul. That's 4 on Anthony Bernero. Five team fouls on Carthage, none whistled on Elmhurst here in the second half. Off balance shot, no good. Ocean Johnson that time, Carthage clears out the rebound. This game has gotten very physical, very chippy, very chirpy. Johnson, a reach foul by Wesley Hooker on Johnson's drive to the basket. First foul of the second half on the Blue Jays. Second on Hooker. Jonathan Zapinski and Bryce Drews checking in now for Elmhurst, replacing Johnson and Thomas. And again, the officials have to talk into the stack. Bilatovic off the inbound feed. Leans in, bumped a couple of times, banked it off the glass, too strong. Where's the foul call there? Nothing there. Calling on one end. Rhodey now backs it off. Gets it to Hooker for 3. Got it, Wesley Hooker. Backs down the 3. He's in double digits now with 10. He's 1 for 5 at the arc. 56-48, Elmhurst. Antoine Nesbitt, the freshman, spin-around move. Got it to Ostojic, couldn't finish. Nice job defensively underneath. That might have been Drews that got a piece of that one. Zapinski to Rhodey, fakes the 3 on Johnson. Into the corner, 3 on the way, and that one back iron. Rebound, Ostojic for Carthage. 12 minutes to play, Carthage down 8. Trying to stay with this Blue Jay team. They led by 7 at the half, Carthage did. Off-balance push there, no call. Nice look, Bladovic to Stojic. And one coming up. Maine South teammates working there on the give and go. Bladovic to Stojic. Kyle Kostas will come in now, replacing A.J. Johnson. Dominic Jenko coming in, the 6'3 senior for Elmhurst. He'll replace Wesley Hooker. Nemi Stojic to complete the three-point play. 6'7 sophomore. Get him into the weight room this offseason. Bulk up a little bit to withstand the rigors of playing in the post in the CCIW. Jenko with it now, 6-point lead. Militello for three, in and out. Back tap to Rohde. Kicks it back out, Jenko. Try to throw it into Zapinski, and it goes out of bounds in the corner, taking a spill in front of the band that time was Drews. He's okay. And 25 remaining. Carthage down six. Mladovic to Horner. Three, no. Battle for the loose ball picked up by Zapinski underneath. Hill outlet to Rohde. Militello thought about it. Got around the defense. Kicks it to Jenko. He'll leave it there. Zapinski coming back over the top to Rohde. Militello to Rohde at the center circle. Seven on the shot clock here. Step back over Horner and good for Rohde. It'll count as a three. 9-point lead now for the Blue Jays. They led by as many as 12 in the first half. Trailed by as many as seven here in the contest. Bladovic going hard to the basket. Zapinski with the foul, third on the team, fourth on Zapinski. We'll get LaVon Thomas back into the ball game here after this free throw attempt by Filip Bulatovic. 18 points tonight for Bulatovic. 6 for 6 now at the free throw line. Ocean Johnson and LaVon Thomas will check in, replacing Zapinski, who has 4 fouls, and Militello also coming out. There you see the line on Bulatovic tonight. Right, 7 for 7. Timeout, Firebirds. 10.5 minutes to go. 7-point game. Blue Jays have outscored Carthage here. 28-14 here in this second half. Carthage 6 for 12 in the second half for the game. 40%. They've missed all four of their three-point shots here in the second half, just 5 for 23 in the game. Meanwhile, the Blue Jays 9 for 19 here in the second half. For the game, 18 of 48, 37%. 5 of 9 at the arc in the second half, 7 for 20 in the game, and they've outshot Carthage at the free throw line, 16 of 21 to 9 of 10, and that's been aided by 3 technical fouls tonight. One on Christian Cook, one on Kyle Shirak. Carthage getting teed up here 3 times in this second half. It's been a chirpy, chippy game. Thomas now. Up top. Drews to Rohde, back to Thomas. Working on a Stojic. Kicks it back out, Jenko. 16-footer good for Dominic Jenko. out of Zionsville, Ohio. Back to a 9-point lead. Nesbitt. And he'll get to the free throw line. The freshman from the Prairie School. Drews picking up his fourth. So Drews and Sapinski each with four personal fouls now for the Blue Jays. This is the freshman, Antoine Nesbitt, joined the team in January, started J term. Originally from Milwaukee, played his high school ball at the Prairie School up in Wind Point, north side of Racine. Jason Antanasoff was his basketball coach. Antanasoff, a Carthage grad, one-time football coach, as Carthage gets the offensive rebound and play is held up here. Took some time back off that reset on the shot clock. It's showing 19. They took 3 seconds off there, put it to 16. For the Firebirds as Bolatovic brings it back in. Nesbitt working on Rohde. Spun around Rohde. Reverse layup. Oh, couldn't get it to fall. Nesbitt with a nice move around Rohde, just didn't finish. Now Thomas. Militello, and an offensive foul. They're going to call him for a wipe away that time as he hooked Kostas on the right block. And for Militello, that is his first. Team fouls are now even at five after Carthage whistled for the first five fouls here in the half. Elmhurst has committed the last five, and now each team with five team fouls. Kostas to Ostojic. Hard off the glass, too strong. Rebound off of Ostojic. Levon Thomas is down underneath the basket here, and play will be halted. He is back under his own power. This game has gotten out of control. The officials have let some things go and then started in the first half. Krishan Cook got whistled for technical for taking a open jumper in front of the Blue Jay bench, and on the way back had something to say about it. Garrett Horner with an intentional foul in that first half. That led to two free throws and a possession. Rohde turnaround in the paint. Nice look to Wesley Hooks, low left. And Hooker able to lay that one in. 12 for Wesley Hooker. Kostas dumps to Nesbitt. Nesbitt. And it blocked by Levon Thomas. Rohde will come clear with it. Stand still, three, won't go. Hooker with the rebound, tried to force it inside to Thomas, intercepted by Bulatovic. Quickly to Ostojic. Ostojic got away with a walk, got it into Nesbitt. Back out it goes. Kostas for three. That one is short. Rebound still loose, now picked up by Ocean Johnson. Johnson getting past Kostas. Reload to Rohde. 10-point advantage here for the Blue Jays, and they'll take a timeout. 8:06 to play, leading by 10. Again, Firebirds with a 38-31 lead at the half, getting outscored here in the second half, 32-15. Carthage just 6-for-16 here in the second half, 19-for-51 in the game. 0-for-5 at the arc here in the second half, 5-for-24 in the game. And this is where we said that Carthage gets into these little funks. And the attention to detail, plus the fact that they've gotten a little chirpy and whistled for a couple of technical fouls, has not helped. That put Rohde at the free throw line, where he is 10-for-10 tonight. That was aided by three technical fouls. here in the game. North Park men are beating Carroll in Waukesha. 8 minutes to play, 62-45. Another game going on. Bernero in now for Carthage, along with Garrett Horner. Krishan Cook back on the floor as well. Thomas cut off by Bernero, gets it to Militello. Militello nearly took it out of bounds to Rohde. Rohde off balance, somehow got that up with the right hand. What a circus play that time by Jake Rohde. Hanging in the air and flipping that ball up with the right hand. Connects and puts the fourth foul on Krishan Cook. 21 on the night for Jake Rohde. Looking for his 11th free throw, and he hits. 11 for 11 now at the line is Jake Rohde. 22 on the night. 66-53, 13-point lead. Pass inside, broken up. Rohde coming down. Offensive foul on Rohde. He and Bernero were exchanging elbows down the floor, and Rohde called for the foul. That could have gone either way. I think Anthony Bernero showing some frustration. Got popped a couple of times, and then on the way down, gave a shot back to Rohde, who in turn delivered a left elbow and got called for the foul. Colton Sigel will check in along with Kyle Kostas for the Firebirds. Cook handling the basketball, driving. Cook flips with the right hand, couldn't get it to fall. Hooker will come down with it. Will feed Militello, shot blocked by Bernero, goes out of bounds off of Bernero. Bernero playing hard with four fouls. Both he and Cook on the floor together, each with four personal fouls. Thomas spins, puts it up with the left hand, couldn't get it to fall. Ocean got the rebound to Hooker for three. That's too strong. Bulanovic pulls down the rebound. To Bernero, laid it up. That should have been a goaltend. And they'll call it. Ball was in the cylinder when it made contact with it. Ocean Johnson touched it while it was in the cylinder. Point deficit. A.J. Johnson in now for the Firebirds, replacing Kyle Kostas. Cook, Sigel, Bulatovic, Bernero, and Johnson out there. Rohde, Thomas, Hooker, Ocean Johnson, and Militello out there for the Blue Jays. Thomas gives it off to Rohde. Running down the left side, was knocked hard to the floor, and the foul called. It's on Krishan Cook, and he is fouled out in his final game in a Carthage uniform. Set to finish his graduate program this spring. Again, got that technical foul, which counted as a personal foul, and it finishes the night. 8 points, two rebounds. He will finish eighth all time in steals for Carthage College. Rohde continues to make free throws. 79% shooter from the line. He's 12 for 12. This is free throw number 13, and good. 24 points for Jake Rohde tonight. He had 21 in the game earlier against Carthage down at Elmhurst. Bladovich had it stripped out of his hand. Tried to make his move to the basket. Militello took it away. To the corner, and Militello for three. Knock it down. Jay Militello. 16-point lead with 6 minutes to play. Bernero Left side, Bulatovic driving, spinning, puts up with the right hand and in. Filip Bulatovic with 22. He will finish the season leading the team in scoring, rebounds, and assists per game. Militello, wipe away Bulatovic, knocked hard to the floor, no call. Sigel, shot blocked by Zapinski. Picked up underneath by Ocean Johnson. Rohde will take a timeout here just across midcourt. 16-point lead, the largest of the game here for the Blue Jays, 73-57. Just over 5 minutes to play in the final game of the season for the Firebirds. The Blue Jays will head into the conference tournament next week. Right now, sitting as a 3 seed with a win today. I want to get that 2 seed. We need some help. Wheaton playing host to Milliken tonight. We'd need to lose that game, force a tie, and then we'd look at tiebreakers as far as that would go for the Blue Jays. In this second half now, Blue Jays 14-28, even 50%. 6-for-12, 50% shooting the three, 34% in the game. Carthage 8-for-19. In the game, 21-of-54, 38%. They've missed all 5 of their 3-pointers tonight in the second half. Carthage just 5-for-24, long ball in the game. They've been outshot at the free throw line. They've been doubled up at the free throw line. 19-24 for the Blue Jays, 10-for-12 for Carthage. Each team with 13 turns, and now the Blue Jays with a 41-29 advantage on the glass, including 13 offensive boards tonight. Sigel's going to have to come back into the game here. Try and sub him out with Nesbitt, but officials say he didn't check in. Zapinski setting a ball screen for Rohde. He's been on fire. 24 points tonight. Into Ocean Johnson through the paint. Blocked by Bernero. Bulatovic picks it up. Second block of the game for Bernero. Coast is cut off in the paint by Johnson to the trailer. A.J. Johnson missed the shot. Laid it short. Cleared out of there by Zapinski to Rohde. Rohde passed Bernero. Kicked it back out. Hooker for three. No. Coast is able to get the board for Carthage. Bulatovic on the drive and the foul call. Zapinski picking up the foul. He is done. He has fouled out. Christian Cook fouling out earlier for the Firebirds. So Zapinski's night is done. 2 points, 7 rebounds tonight for Zapinski. And Bulatovic now back at the line will shoot 2. He's hit all 8 of his free throws tonight. Gone 9-for-9 at the line tonight. 24 points for Filip Bulatovic, 73-59 Elmhurst. Wesley Hooker a double-double tonight. 12 points, 10 boards. Gives it off to Ocean Johnson, now to Rohde. To Militello on the left block. Backdoor feed, LaVon Thomas missed the shot, got his own rebound. Swatted at by Nesbitt and Bulatovic, and I believe Bulatovic will get the foul.
Time is off 11, Philip Bulatovic.
third on Bilatovic. Team eighth, LaVon Thomas at the free throw line. Drops the first. Second one on the way and good for Thomas. 10 points now for Thomas to go with seven rebounds. 75-59, under 4 minutes to play. Bulatovic for three, barely drew iron. There were four blue jerseys underneath looking for that rebound. Thomas leaves it for Hooker. Flip to the corner, Rohde. Denied by Bernero, forced the turnover. 14 turns for the Blue Jays tonight. Bulatovic hard to the basket. Oh, in and out, no good. Bernero with the offensive board, goes back up with it and draws the foul. An emotional Anthony Bernero tonight. He's brought the fire all game long. First extended minutes for Bernero in quite some time. Again, he had that bad ankle injury, that dislocated ankle, December 1st in the latter stages of that Wheaton game, and ended up missing seven games, about 6 weeks. Came back in mid-January. Tyler Guest in there now. Bernero missed the second. Militello with the rebound. 75-60. Carthage had a 7-point lead at the half, but just Blue Jays got after it right away. You knew they would. Very good team. Steve Jerkovic mentioning to me that he thought this was the most experienced team in the league. Play hard. They play tough. It's been all that tonight. Very physical, very emotional game. Rohde at the buzzer. The shot clock going down. Rohde now with 26. Nesbitt, their late whistle. They're going to call an offensive foul. Well, that's seniority there. The freshman Nesbitt colliding with Rohde. Rohde, the senior, getting the benefit of that call. Hooker working on Kostas. Militello for three. That one's no good. Tyler Guest getting the rebound in front of Ocean Johnson. Kostas splits the defense, goes up and draws the foul, and takes the official with him. Collided with the official underneath. Militello picks up the foul, his third. This will put Kostas at the line shooting two. Great looking freshman, Kyle Kostas. 11 points tonight. Make it 12 to go with seven rebounds. He's the leading rebounder for Carthage tonight with seven. Tell you what, this is a very good nucleus to build around offensively. This team's just got to get better defensively. They have to buy into the defense. Under 2 minutes to play. Elmhurst is going to pick up the win. Get to 11-5. Kyle Shirak going to get one more curtain call here. He's going to get the game next dead ball. Thomas from Rohde. Blocked by Bernero. Guest picks it up. Outlets to Bulatovic. One on two. Kostas underneath to Antoine. And Antoine Nesbitt. Nice move at the basket. 3 points tonight for Nesbitt. Rohde back out to Hooker. Now Thomas backing in on Bernero. And Bernero called for the foul. Anthony Bernero. Let's see who they're going to call. That's his fifth. 10th team foul, so Thomas will shoot two. Blue Jays will shoot two the rest of the way out. Stojic and Shirak will come in as Bernero joins Krishan Cook fouling out here today. Don't mind the effort by Anthony Bernero tonight. 5 points, two rebounds, two blocks. Brought some emotion out there tonight. Get that ankle properly healed, bulk up a little bit. Again, he was on quite a roll early in the season, and then that bad ankle injury in the final seconds of a game against Wheaton here at home on December 1st. That flipped the season completely around for Bernero. Guest pass broken up by Ocean Johnson, bouncing around up into the third row. The Firebirds go to 2-14, 9-16 overall. It's a young team that has some potential offensively next year. They just got to get better defensively. Shirak for three and got it. How about that? Hey, you like to see that, Kyle Shirak. Academic All-Conference for 3 years. 3.9 GPA here at Carthage. Going to become a high school math teacher. He's out there student teaching already. Bittersweet moment for Kyle Shirak. He's been a leader. Led this team this season as captain and brought it practice every day. Behind the back feed by Rohde to Militello. Missed the shot. Guest with the rebound. Final 3 seconds here. Guest for the deep three. No good. Thomas got the board, and that's all she wrote here tonight. 79-66, your final, as the Blue Jays sweep the season series from the Firebirds, go to 11-5 in conference play, 19-6. They're going to be a tough out in the conference tournament that starts next week. Meanwhile, for the Firebirds, their season comes to an end here at home. 2-14, 9-16 in Steve Jurkovic's second season at the helm. There you look at the final numbers. Carthage again got cold here in the second half, missed all seven of their three-point shots. They led by seven at the half, 38-31. Blue Jays jumped out, 9-2 run to start the second half, and they kept it going. Just too much experience on that Blue Jay team as they finish off the Firebirds here tonight. Your final numbers, Carthage 23 of 61, 37%, just 6 of 28 from the arc, 21%. And 14 of 18 from the free throw line. Meanwhile, the Blue Jays, 24 of 64, 37%. 8 for 25 at the arc, 32%. And 23 of 28. They outshot the Firebirds 28 to 18 at the foul line tonight. Out-rebounded the Firebirds 47-35, including 14 on the offensive glass for the Blue Jays. Carthage with 8 offensive boards. And it was a physical, as I said, a chippy and chirpy kind of game here tonight between these two rivals. And it was the Blue Jays, their experience winning out. Jake Rohde with 26 points to lead the way for the Elmhurst Blue Jays. He was 5 of 8 from the field, 3 of those triples, but went 13 for 13 at the line. Had 4 rebounds, 4 assists, and 4 steals tonight. Meanwhile, it was Filip Bulatovic, the leading scorer for the Firebirds tonight. 24 points, 7 of 18 from the field. He went 9 of 9 at the free throw line. Had 6 rebounds, 5 assists, and 2 steals. So Rohde with 26, leading 4 in double figures, including a double-double tonight by Wesley Hooker. 12 points, 11 rebounds for Hooker tonight. LaVon Thomas, 12 points, 7 rebounds. And Jay Militello, 17 points and 5 boards tonight. Stay with us. Steve Jurkovic will join us momentarily here with our final postgame of the season. Carthage dropping a 79-66 decision to the Elmhurst Blue Jays. John Weiser back with you at the Tarble Arena, 79-66, the final. Very physical, very emotional ball game here tonight. Carthage whistled for three technical fouls and one intentional foul here tonight. Two foul outs by Carthage. Christian Cook fouling out with just 8 points tonight. Anthony Bernero fouling out. Zapinski fouling out for Elmhurst. Carthage called for 21 fouls tonight. Let's run down the individual numbers. It was Bulatovic with 24, including 9 for 9 at the free throw line for Phillip. If he can get that free throw shooting under control and do this night in and night out, he'll average 25 points a game. That would be a lock. He'll have another opportunity next season as a senior and most likely captain of this team next year. Kyle Kostas with 12 tonight. He's another link into next season. He has got a good shooting touch. 4 for 9 tonight from the field, 3 for 4 at the line, and led the team in rebounds with 7 tonight. Kyle Kostas with 12 points and 7 rebounds. 8 points for Christian Cook. We mentioned Cook picking up that technical foul in the first half and eventually fouling out here in the second half. 3 for 8 from the field, including a pair of three-pointers for Cook tonight. He will finish his career at Carthage top 10 in steals, as he'll finish in the 8th spot all time in Carthage men's basketball history. I believe it was 47 coming into the game here tonight. Cook finished 6 points for Nemi Ostojic off the bench tonight. 3 for 5, 4 rebounds, and 2 steals for Ostojic tonight. Five points for Anthony Bernero. He fouled out of the ball game in the final minute. Bernero brought some emotion tonight. 2 for 3 from the field, 1 for 2 at the line, 2 rebounds, 3 block shots to lead Carthage in that category tonight. Bernero with 5 points. 3 points each for Colton Sigel and Antoine Nesbitt, two guys that will be counted on for some of the offense again next year. Again, we never really got to see a full potential out of Nesbitt through a full camp and full season. So kind of an incomplete grade, if you will, for Antoine Nesbitt as he joined the team at the start of January, the J term. Played 12 games with Carthage, averaged 3.7 points and just over 1 rebound per contest. Anxious to see what he's going to deliver next year. Sigel, 1 for 4. That was a 3, finishing with 3 points. Kyle Shirak in his final game, 3 points tonight. That was a 3-pointer coming here toward the end. But again, the numbers aren't going to say much for Kyle, but it's what he brought in game out, practice every day. He was there. He was the leader of this team. And that wraps up the scoring for Carthage here tonight as they fall 79-66, joined now by head coach Steve Jerkovic. And maybe a lesson a little bit here tonight and just how to keep your composure in what is going to be a physical league.
For sure.
Just have to keep your composure.
Yeah, a little unlucky in some of those. It was just the, as always, in a physical game that we wanted to compete. We wanted to be the more aggressive, tougher team. And, you know, there a couple times you were the second guy in that gets called, and unfortunately that's the case. And it was nothing over the top language-wise or anything of that nature. It was just people getting tangled up in a contested CCIW game. But, you know, I thought we battled our butts off in the first half. We won the rebounding battle and the story of the year in the second half. We just couldn't clean it up off the boards. And those are back-breaking plays. The offensive rebound kickouts for threes, and those are tough.
Very tough, but love the effort tonight. I thought for almost a full 40 minutes you brought emotion, you brought physicality, you were standing toe-to-toe with a nationally ranked team, 15th ranked Blue
Jays.
That's
a really good basketball team, too. You got six-year guys, fifth-year guys out there. They've been through it all. They have. And unfortunately, obviously, we know this is not the way we wanted this year to go. We took a couple different turns throughout, but we competed with one of the best teams in the country and came up short at the end, unfortunately. That's a veteran team, like I said, but things that we need to learn and take away from this year going forward.
I mentioned, I was just talking as you came up about the seniors tonight, Kyle Shirak and Tyler Guest and Krishan Cook. More importantly, I think Kyle Shirak, you know, I look at a kid here, he's a program kid, 4 years in the program, and did everything you asked of him to do.
One of the best teammates, one of the best practicers that I've ever been around. He brought it every single day. He was the most prepared player. He knew the scouting report to a T, and just a great leader and friend for all the guys in the building. But, I mean, his contributions are, I guess, undescribable for what he really brought to all of us. And like you said, sometimes the stats at the end of the day don't always show what he brought. And we're going to miss him. I mean, everything that he brought to this team for the last 4 years was appreciated too. And Chris Cook is, man, has he had a tough go of it over his 4 years. He's battled every injury possible, including this year again. Finally, last year he was healthy, didn't get the waiver for the COVID year. This year, healthy at the beginning, what'd he play? The first three, gets hurt again and misses the next 10. And that's just been the story of him, unfortunately. And he's going to walk out of here in the summer with a master's degree from Carthage, and I couldn't be happier for Chris going forward. And Tyler Guest, one of the most likable guys in the program, just an infectious personality, comes to work every single day, also going to get his master's degree in sports management from Carthage this year, and couldn't have asked for a better somebody to join the team for a one-year run.
And another unsung senior, Noah Howard, who came in as a student assistant. Talk about his role this year.
Again, and Noah's a guy who decided to go to the coaching route this year, and he learned as it went. It's always tough to hang up the shoes. It really is. And he decided to go on the bench side of it, and he learned a lot this year. He helped us out a ton from game planning, preparation, on court, and he's going to do even more for us next year and going forward.
So going forward with this team, I think offensively you've got enough scoring, you got to get tougher on the defensive 100, side.
100%, and that was the talk in the locker room today. And if we compete and we fight with that effort, offense is going to take care of itself. That should never be the concern. We have enough talented offensive players that can shoot it, that can attack it. It needs to come to us where we need to figure out what's the best way defensively that all of our pieces work together. And we had moments where we were really good. And then I think we had four times in the first half where we got three stops in a row. And then the second half, you'd get two, hit a three, hit, get two stops, offensive rebound put back. And those are the ones, like I said, those are back-breaking plays in a close game.
Handicap for me this six-team conference tournament. This might be as wide open a conference tournament as there's been in quite some time.
There's so many good teams, really. Milliken's playing outstanding right now. North Central, you can't count out ever with the Hellwigs, how they play. They've been through it, and we know the teams that are going to get, I think it's Wesley and Wheaton probably getting the top two seeds, but either way, really good teams. It's going to be a good CCIW tournament for sure.
Let me ask you one more question before I let you go, and that is conference-wise, I think it's great to see Milliken have the year they had. I think that lifts everybody up. Carroll's going to be tough next year with their young nucleus that they've got. Milliken, if they keep it together, Augustana building
another
around Dan
too,
Carr.
Man.
We talked about it. This league might flip around a little bit. There's going to be, I think, maybe seven or eight teams that are going to be really battling it out for those six spots.
I really think so. It should be as open as any year next year. It's on us to put in that work in the offseason. And we're going to have our end-of-year meetings to see what we need to work on individually, collectively as a group. And, you know, it's a long ways away till October 15th. But we can't waste any weeks, any months going forward. We need to compete and work every single day to give ourselves the best chance possible for next year.
Steve, thank you so much for your gracious time, time and again at the end of ball games. I know a lot of times it's not fun coming up when you lose, and we appreciate your effort making this and your second year. I know you're going to get this thing turned around.
Mr. Weiser, thank you for everything. Again, you said it best. It's not how we wanted this year to go. Feel bad for the seniors sending them out this way, but I really like this young core, this young nucleus of pieces that we have. And now, like you said, it's on us to put in that work and be ready to compete next year, specifically on the defensive end.
Get on that recruiting train, and we'll talk to you again next fall.
Roger, thank you.
You bet. Steve Jurakovic, head basketball coach here at Carthage College, wrapping up our season here. 79-66, the final. The Blue Jays take down the Firebirds. One more look at the numbers. There they are. And as Steve mentioned, the rebounding total, boy, 47-35. Carthage had the edge at the half on the glass. If I could find my score sheet here from the first half amongst all my papers here. Carthage had the advantage on the glass by 4, I believe it was, at the end of the first half. And here, I have it right here. And the rebounding totals, by 3. 23-20 advantage on the glass, but then end up in the game getting out-rebounded 47-35. And as Steve mentioned, that is your storyline there. And trying to keep your composure a little bit. As I said, a classic physical ball game, and a lot of chirping back and forth, and unfortunately Carthage got caught up in that tonight, and that led to a couple of technical fouls. And again, I think if you bring that level of competitiveness in and night out for this Carthage team, they're going to be just fine next season. Big thank you again to Mike Love, who puts together our video streams here at Carthage College. He is our executive producer. John Voinovich is our director emeritus, I guess you could say, here for all of what we do here. John does a fantastic job getting the students organized and working on things. Joel Rapp has been our director here for most of the season, also working graphics tonight, and our two camera people, Kaylee and Lorelei, we thank you as well. I'm John Weiser. I'm glad you tuned into our broadcast this season. We'll have more for you coming up. We got men's volleyball Wednesday night, and of course men's and women's lacrosse, and then baseball and softball coming up. So we'll see each other again down the road here, starting this Wednesday night with men's volleyball. Until then, have a great weekend. Thanks for tuning in, everyone. Thank you for watching Carthage Athletics. Go Firebirds!